My name is Sohail, and my last name is Sohail.
Call me Mo.
And my name is Behdad.
Miriam.
Yes.
My name is David Vee. I'm an Australian, and for the last 2.5 years, I've been living in Iran, and this is my story.
Do you think the Islamic Republic of Iran is very religious?
The name Islamic Republic, at the first step, should be self-referring and self-revealing. Well, should be religious. But I'll tell you that between these two words, Islamic and republics, from the point of philosophy, there is a paradox.
It's an enigma. Nobody really knows what happens in this country. Because the powers that be don't want people to know exactly what's happening. Yeah, sure, there are restrictions here that can make life seem pretty limited, miserable, and frustrating. But what I'm going to show you is a more positive side of Iran. There's no clubs. There's no bars, there's no bikinis. So, what do the Persians do to have fun?
If you have a connection, you can do all. You can do all things in Iran.
Don't touch my camera.
Because you have no permission to take a photo with everybody.
We do.
You can't.
We do.
You can't.
We do. Okay.
No photo.
Who are you?
No photo.
You can't just grab your camera and go out on the street filming over here. You need a permit from the authorities. And this can take up to 12 months. And most of the time it's refused. No, I didn't get a permit. But that wasn't going to stop me from my mission. Find out what's going on over there. To get inside the Persian site, you can't remotely look like you are filming on the street over here or doing any type of interview. Most of the interviews were done behind closed doors. When I first came to Iran, I was pleasantly surprised by the number of active artists and art galleries that there is. Today, we're going to head off downtown and have a little look-see at one. But first, we must negotiate the traffic. It's a living, breathing, throbbing organism. You can't go around it. You've got to go through it. Just grab your car keys and dive on in, and inshallah, you'll make it through to the other side. Road rules,
and... I'm the art director of Seyhun Art Gallery in Tehran. The philosophy behind the gallery is to promote young, talented artists.
Do you think the government
supports the arts in Tehran?
I cannot say 100%. They try, but maybe they don't know how. Actually, my father had an exhibition with Salvador Dali.
Really?
And Picasso. It was a long time ago, before the revolution.
I believe you're a student.
I was. I got expelled.
You got expelled?
Yeah.
Because?
Because. They're not telling you how to make sculpture. From your mind, from your brain. It's not like that. They just can teach you, you know, the techniques. For example, if you want to make a sculpture, whatever you want, we don't give a shit what you want to make. But if you want to do it this way. You have to make an armature and after put some clay in it and then, I don't know, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah, they're not telling you that. For example, look, this is your sculpture, right? We're not giving a shit that you want to make it into a penis or into a, I don't know, David of Michelangelo, I know, whatever. They're not, you know, talking about the issue of the sculpture. They're just talking about the techniques. Why on earth would anyone let in Islamic Republic of Iran to put a condom this much obvious in a hand of a mermaid? There is no way, that's not gonna happen. There's no way that is gonna happen. They're not gonna allow me, you know?
You are being told that you're gonna go to Iran. Either being Iranian and have lived in the outside Iran for so many years, or you're a foreigner. The first thing that comes to your mind is, shit, I'm going to Iran. It's not tropical Barbados, okay? It's Iran. Can you adapt to Iran? I mean, Iran is it's not like you're walking into Washington, D.C., or you're walking to Paris. It's like they put you in Lhasa, Tibet. Can you adapt to the atmosphere, environment, people?
کشوری که آدم بره در جای خودش ملت‌ها با هم خوب هستن این دولت‌ها هستن که سیاست سرشون نمیشه و ملت‌ها رو به جون هم انداختن
تهران It's a big, crowded, manic city. And with 17 million people, some travellers can find it overbearing. What do you think about wearing the hijab?
It's fine.
It's tiring.
It's boring.
No. اصلا حجاب اجباری دوست ندارم.
No, not a good idea.
Okay.
Of course not. Wearing it outside is not a big problem, but you have to wear it in the hotels, you have to wear it in restaurants, you have to eat with it, you have to sit with it in taxis, in the metro. It's from warm to cold to warm again to the airco to the... It's really impractical. It's not so practical. And I don't even think about summer. In summer it must be really horrible.
As long as you have to wear a hijab to go running in the park, hijab and long pants, and you cannot play tennis with your husband outside.
professional and they make
a good living,
yeah, a lot of money. For them it's not even interesting to go to Europe. The good players will at least $300,000 a year.
Really?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Oh. And there are more, it's up to $1 million a year.
Film too long at one location and the police or someone else would come over and ask me to stop. Filming is forbidden.
Listen to the rhythm flow. What is the Islamic Republic of Iran? What is it? Okay, it's definitely not uptown Tehran. Okay, and it's definitely not midtown Tehran either. It's definitely downtown, below downtown Tehran. Yes, that's Islamic Republic. Okay, and it's not Islamic Republic of this government. It's Islamic, and it was always like that. There's people that really, really believe in their religion.
Iran has 80 million people. If there was one country where the word dichotomy had to be used, it would be Iran. Paradoxically, religion is everywhere, yet nowhere. It's part Middle East, part Western, an interesting mix. They are exciting people. They do, somehow, manage to live normal lives. Yet, you never really know where you stand with Iranians. It's complicated. There is no place on Earth like planet Persia. They all love their country, and they all have Islam in their hearts. Religion is incorporated into their daily lives. They all believe in a God. But compared to a country like Pakistan, the majority rarely go to the mosques. Most Iranians under the age of 30 stated they had been to a mosque only 4 or 5 times in their life.
Yeah, that's surprising, you know. You have an image of Iranian people so religious, so I don't know, but they don't.
What about Qazvin, you know? Jokes about Qazvin.
That's northwest, is it?
Yeah. You know the jokes of the Qazvin?
No. Actually, do you know some good jokes about?
They're all erotic Qazvin jokes, you know? It's an erotic sexual and city, yeah.
Sexual jokes?
Homosexual. Yeah, yeah.
Homosexual?
Yeah. Qazvin.
I'm sure the people would like to hear some of these jokes.
All of these jokes. I don't know any jokes. I don't care about jokes in my life.
Alright. So back to the music.
Grumbles.
Sorry?
Grumbles.
How much do they charge for the studio?
Yeah. Here, that's very expensive. That's about $24.
For 1 hour or two?
I've been waiting in love.
Hey man, how are you? Salam. But I will come without my car next time.
Okay, machine car?
Yeah, no car. Tonight we're in Tehran. We're in a rehearsal studio, in Avenger rehearsal studio, and we've got two members of Azi Rock. Mm-hmm. We've got Kazra.
Yeah.
And Sohail.
Azi Rock.
Sorry. The Bakshi. So, what style of music is the Bakshi? Do they make amplifiers in Iran?
No, which they just import.
Guitars? They make electric guitars?
There is, I think, as I know, there's one person that do that custom, that make some custom guitars.
How often do you rehearse?
Pardon me?
How often do you rehearse? Once a week?
Nowadays there'll be a festival, 5 or 6 days a week.
So you're a Muslim?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You're a Muslim?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Singer, he sings in English, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
And why is this? What about Farsi? It's a nice language.
I told you that we got a demo album in Farsi, but it doesn't work, I think. It doesn't work in Farsi. Because, English is kind of universal language and everyone all around the world can understand English.
Thanks guys for coming tonight.
You're welcome, thank
Good
you.
Luck
thank you.
For the future.
Right. Hope to see us in Sydney or Melbourne.
When there's a river and you're sitting underneath the blossoms, etc., it's beautiful. It's very relaxing. You can smoke a pipe. That's very nice, but yeah, just to say, okay, for example, after this, you could say, let's go out and have a beer together. You cannot. So.
We are not like you, like Australia, that we can surf and we can do all of those things that you do over there. Yeah. We have to use the least situations that we have, whatever we get. That's it. I'm saying I'm not loving the system, I'm not loving where it goes, but still we have few things to live with. Like whatever I do, I come here and I skate, I watch American TV, I for example play baseball, I get a job maybe for like $500 a month. That's enough for me, but that's not all.
outside of Surrey. I can't forget our better days. I can't forget your lovely man. Without you here, and I'll go crazy. Come back forever, come together. I can't forget you, I can't be happy. Because you're my cure in this painful world.
Because they are always in fight with tensions in personal level, family level, social level, so they just lost their tolerance. But certainly it's in related with some other problems that we face in every day of our lives.
Things you said were true. Gave me a clue, but words won't make me high. So I will hold you, I will keep you dry from the heaviness of time. My mind's keeping you alive. I'm just drifting back in time. I know someone else among the rest, looking for a thrill, and I'm just making you rely on a handful of lies I used to tell myself. That your eyes fell on the ground and it was covered by the snow. I stole them, I could please you, I could make you smile. I don't know how could I, but blaming yourself won't just let it go from the memory of time. The song that made me kiss you, the kiss that made me say I love you. It's not been a long time since then, I know. The time is just a figure, and I'm just stuck inside of.
One of the first things an Iranian will ask you in a taxi or in a shop when you just start talking, what do you think about Iran? They always ask. They always ask. They're very curious. Very.
As soon as you get your camera out, it's a big event. Everyone looks. People notice.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Kharaji.
Kha.
Kha.
Re.
Kha. Re.
Ji.
Ji. Kharaji.
Okay.
What do you think about the Iranian women? Do you think the Italian women are better looking?
I think veil thing.
The hijab.
Yeah, hijab. That lets you see on the face only. I find it quite sexy. I mean, you don't need to show much.
okay, women wear scarves and rupush or chadors or whatever. That's, you know, it's a rule. It's a rule. But we're live here. You know, we go to parties, we go out, we have restaurants. Okay, there's no alcohol in restaurants, there's no clubs, there's no bars or anything like this. But there's everything's inside. Mm. Everything's inside, and you know, it's not hush hush. Everybody knows it. Everybody does it. It's like, okay, over there, everything's outside. You go out, you go do this, do that, you run around. Here, everything's inside. This is the way it has happened.
It is one of the most famous shopping centers in Tehran. Situated in the west of Tehran, people come to eat and to relax. The shopping is strictly upmarket, with brand names like Chanel, Cartier, and Dolce & Gabbana. Thursday night, the end of the working week, is the busiest night. There is free Wi-Fi throughout the plaza. It's a place for families and friends to spend time in a calm atmosphere. A place for the youth of Tehran to hang, check each other out, spend a few hours.
You gave me some more, man. Yeah, you wanna smoke some more. I mean, you got some Rizla. And shit, the day is so boring ass shit. How can you feel my motherfucking ass shit? I say, when we getting on, chain of London and a chillin', smoking some rolls and jaws and a foilin'. We can't in our tone, no, we never fakin', without the future home. Rollin' Rizala with my nigga Izala, getting on the smoke with jaws. Every bitch and hoes that I know, smoking with me and my dogs.
You live near each other in the States, your friends? Or?
Yeah. Yes.
Speak Farsi at home?
Yeah. Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Most of the times.
The cursing force.
The cursing force.
Yes.
So what do you think about living in Tehran?
I think it's interesting.
It's interesting.
Hey, man.
Nothing, man.
Superman, yeah.
It's cool.
Cool, it's cool.
Thanks, man.
So sexy.
Golestan Shopping Center, or Goli, is situated on Iran Zamin Street. This is a famous pickup street. Groups of youths drive up and down, swapping phone numbers and stopping to flirt. The police constantly try to thwart this. Cars are regularly impounded for 10 days or even longer. Every night there is drama on Iran Zamin Street. Tonight there was a huge fight.
Yo.
واسه آینده ما نداریم هیچ کدوم هدف، میریم گوری میشینیم و هی میکشیم علف کونمون گشاده و گشادیش به جاس بیستا میشیم میریم تانا میدوزدیم لباس ایرانی ایم ولی داریم فاز لاس وگاس، ما با یه اکیپ خاص میشیم از بقیه جدا، نگروس توی قورباغه یه رپر خدا شما چاغلین و فاکو و همه شما افتخارت اینه که میزنی الستی چاغل برو خونه بازی کن با پی اس 3 اینجا شهرک قورباغه توش میدون جنگ همه سربازیم یه جورای سولجر گنگ سمت منه که میخوری یه مشت قشنگ حالا میشینیم و میچاقیم یه جوک بعد بنگ اینقدر میکشی تو خون بریزه از چشای من حالا میرم گلی میکنم من همه رو نگاه یکی رو مخ میکنم در میارم از تنش لباس میبوسم لباشو که رنگش بوده سرخی گلاس آلات و چغال باید بفهمی که رب دست ماست راستی پرن ننه تو گذاشتن سایت بنگ راست دیگه یا چی بگیم بی خیال فاکوی راست
خوب من
All a lot to rap, no stones going in prison. 78 to your homies with me, hustling for money for cookie. Won't give me time, boys. Selling books and toys, get some bitches on the street for watching. Look for some super power, money to us are coming. Depending so much, we jobless. Everybody waiting for one more homeless. Never stay at home, my honey smoking the door. Life has been beautiful, never felt alone like this before. All of my homies not gone, some of them dead and some of them flown. Now we all alone, rapping to set home. Dedicate this song to Danny's unknown, known, what was wrong. We missing them all, cause I know when they come back, I'll keep on niggas on.
But the second thing is that in any religious government, apparently it is religious. But essentially and inherently it is religion stricken, not religious itself.
The Persian psyche, a difficult one to understand. More than 2 years here, and it's still a mystery to me. An infectious lust for life, a jingoistic love for their country. The ancient and the modern live and play side by side.
Iranians love their bread and take it very seriously. It's a big part of their daily menu. They think nothing of lining up for 30 to 40 minutes just to get their favorite.
زیاد بد نیست.
انگلیسی بلدی؟
Yes.
Yes. Oh. How are you?
Where are you come from?
I'm from Australia.
Australia?
Yes. So
what is your job about the bread and the bacon?
I just make a story.
Do you like this kind of bread?
Sangak?
Yes. Sangha.
Yes, I like it.
You are good this.
This shop was selling sangak. Sangak means little stone. They use small stones when they're baking, which gives extra heat to the bread.
Very hot.
Very hot.
Very.
So which bread is the best in Iran?
The best is sangak.
So babari?
You like?
A young lad from the country, new to the town. I walked the wet streets feeling lonely and down. I looked up from the pavement, saw a neon light. Inside it was cozy and modern and bright. I went to the counter, said, "Excuse me, miss, I've been walking all day and I'm dying for a place to sit." She said, "This isn't some hostel for the unclean. To sit here, you gotta drink the juice of the bean. Oh, the juice of the bean, the juice of the bean. The mesmerizing alchemy of grounds and steam. At that very place, on that very eve, I fell in love with that girl and with the juice of the bean. Well, that girl, she didn't love me, she liked the inner city types. But the juice of the bean, it loved me morning and night. I'd start each day with that aromatic kiss to keep my mind in perpetual bliss. I held down a job, I was doing alright, but my 10-a-day addiction I kept out of sight. And when I was up, the days just flew by, and I became an intellectual, socializing kind of guy. I'm the juice of the bean, the juice of the bean, that mesmerizing alchemy of grounds and steam. I'd say, actually, I feel like the modern generation Generation X has been disenfranchised by the dumbing down of the suburban SUV driving sub-intellectual superclass, don't you agree? Oh, well, the crush, when it came like a train steaming through the frothy tunnel where once was my brain. I couldn't get to sleep, couldn't wake up on time. Lost my job and my flat, and I should have seen the signs. My intellectual friends gave me my marching orders, said I developed irritating personality disorders. Besides, they told me these days that modern day thinkers are strictly decaf latte on soy milk drinkers. Oh, the juice of the bean, the juice of the bean, that mesmerizing alchemy of grounds and steam. My teeth have gone brown, I've got spasmed intestines. So I'll take just one more cup of that juice of the bean.
One explanation is that, sorry to say that, they're so frustrated, and the street is the only place where they can express their anger, and you can see it. And I think that is actually is like a theater.
Coffee shops, is it like
coffee shops, yeah.
A hangout that's cool for everyone to go, like you?
Not for everyone, it doesn't suit everyone, you know. In Iran, coffee shops are full of, you know, fakey artists. They're just faking it, yeah.
Why? They're faking, because it's cool to be an artist, they can...
Yeah, it's cool to be an artist, but they're too much fat ass, you know, they're fat ass, they don't work. They just sit around and act like they're artists. For example,
like
I know...
You.
Yeah, exactly. I'm becoming one of them. Seriously, I'm becoming a fat ass.
One day you get out, you see commandos in the street. Another day you get out, you see fashion police in the street. The next day, there's nobody. There's just traffic. And you go to a party here, you have a blast. You saying, oh, and first of all, it's just because that, you know, there is so much going on here that when you do go out, you do something. You really do it because you really want to do it. You don't do it because, oh, I need to fill up my day.
سنگمو میخواد.
ببینم چی کار میکنید.
عاشق وفادار چه دیدی از من حبیبم گلنار که دادی آخر فریبم گلنار
مرسی.
The first time I came to Darakay, I was blown out. The atmosphere is so relaxed and jovial. There's musicians, tea houses, restaurants. There's people having picnics, laughing, dancing, singing. People from all age groups, from 5 to 85. It's a chance to escape and let your hair down. Some people go up very early. If you leave at 7 in the morning, some people are already coming down, leaving at 4. I suppose.
نقاشی رنگ روغن، پورتره و منظره کارهای ناترالیستی.
اوکی، و این کارهای مثلا از این کارهای شما انجام میدین؟
کار رو صخره و
اینا همش شعرن؟
بله، شعران، شعر مولانا، سعدی، حافظ، بزرگان جهان.
اوکی، بله، اینا رو چی کارید؟ اینا رو مثلا میفروشید؟
بله، برای مردم در واقع خرید میکنن، تو خونه هاشون میذارن.
آها، اوکی.
He painted that, did he?
دیدی چه
نقاشی کردی؟
بله بله.
یه
کارهای عکاسی هم میکنم خودم.
کارهای عکاسی هم میکنم. آره. مثلا به من میتونی بگید این چی نوشته روش؟
شعر مولاناست. جسم خاک از عشق بر افلاک شد.
یعنی
کوه
چی؟
در رقص آمد و چالاک شد. جسم خاکی ما، همین جسم بر کالبدهای ما، میگه با اینکه رو زمینه ولی وقتی با عشق هماهنگ بشه میره آسمان ها، صعود میکنه، اوج میگیره به آسمان ها. کوه در رقص آمد و چالاک شد. کوه از اون انرژی میگیره، به رقص میاد، به وزن میاد و اون شکوهش رو نشون میده.
واو، اوکی، خیلی قشنگ بود. مرسی، مرسی.
مولانا یکی از بزرگترین شاعران جهان.
بله.
He's selling them.
این دایر ترنسته میکوه پاپلونه رو دار.
هلو شما خوبی؟
سلامت باشید.
اوکی مرسی. شما از بالا میمدین؟
من از پایین داشتم تازه میرفتم بالا.
آها.
طبقی هدفایی که دارم همیشه باید برم کو، به خاطر هم بعد از رو الان جاییدم میام چون کار میکنم نمیرسم زودتر بیام برم بالا.
اینه روسری برای چیه؟
من اینو مادر بزرگم به من داده. بعدا جریانش این که اینو یادگاری به من داده و من هر موقع اینو میندازم روی سرم خودم آروم میشم، آروم میشم، آرومش پیدا میکنم. ببینم
حکم
میکنه ایرم از اون جدا فردا جدایی
نمیدیم. اسم شما؟
علی هادیان.
اوکی، و چند ساله این
کار
انجام
میدید؟
12 سال. 12 سال. شما دست میتونه میتونید یا این کار ببینید مثلا یه لیسی برای این پشتش چیه؟ اینا
تزمیمیه؟ این از 6 تا قطعه این ساز تشکیل شده. اولین قطعه که داشتی شده این پوسته.
بله.
بعد این قسمتش از چوبیه، بهش میگن کمان یا طوقه. این قسمتش هست که بهش میگن حلقه.
اوکی.
این میخایی که این زیر این حلقه ها رو میگرداشته بهش میگن میخکوب. این میخایی که اینجا این پوست رو نگر میداره این دور بهش میگن گلمیخ.
اوکی.
یه چیزی هم اینجا داره که به این میگن انگشتی یا شستی.
آها. اوکی.
با شست رو این دفعه میگن
در بود. آها. اوکی. روی این چی نوشته؟
نوشته دفت بود و سرانگوشت تو نام علی.
آها، یه بازی برای ما، یه چیز کوچولویی.
Changed my life forever. I've had a blast while I've been living here, but could I spend the rest of my days in Iran? Anyway, I'm going to read the paper. Khudafez.
before the revolution anyway.
Yes. Yes.
Things were a bit different then.